لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا.
And as for who it is that it is obligatory upon them to fast, the scholars have reached consensus that it is obligatory to fast for the people who contain these characteristics: al-Muslim, al-Aqil, al-Baligh, al-Sahih, al-Muqeem. The one who has entered Islam, the one who is sane, who has control over their mind, al-Aqil, wal-Baligh, the one who reached the age of maturity, that they can distinguish between right and wrong, and therefore they became responsible for the obligatory duties in Islam. Al-Sahih, the one who has good health, that enables them to fast, that doesn't prevent them from fast. And al-Muqeem, the one who is not a traveler, the resident. Yani the Muslim who is sane, who has reached the age of responsibility, who is healthy and resident, it is obligatory upon that person to fast. And it is also additionally obligatory upon the woman to fast, and it's obligatory upon her to fast if she is free, yani tahira, free from al-hayd wal-nifas, yani she is not in the state of yani hamensis, or the condition after the delivery of the child, and postpartum bleeding. As far as yani those who are obligated to fast, there is some discussion here that we want to come to if we have time. And we must discuss this matter. Rather, we should discuss it now. And that is the question that there is great difference of opinion about. And we don't have time to go into the detail of it, but we want to mention that indeed there are some people who it is agreed upon that they are yani free from the obligation of fasting, and that those people yani must, like the elderly person, elderly man or elderly woman, who is able only to fast with great difficulty, then that person yani can feed a poor person for every day that they don't fast. And included amongst them, according to a minority opinion, which is the stronger opinion, is the pregnant woman and the breastfeeding woman. Shaykh Al-Albani, rahimahullah, when he was asked about this issue of the pregnant woman and the breastfeeding woman, a person said, I read in a book that they don't have to fast and they don't have to make up the days, they only have to feed. And a poor person, the Shaykh said, لَا يَجِبُ عَلَيْهَا الْقَضَاءُ وَإِنَّمَا يَجِبُ عَلَيْهَا الْكَفَّارَةُ عَنْ كُلِّ يَوْمٍ مِسْكِينًا. Yani that it is not obligatory upon the pregnant woman and the breastfeeding woman to make up the days that they miss from fasting due to difficulty of fasting because of the condition, but rather what is obligatory upon them is the yani expiation for every day by feeding a poor person. From amongst the evidences concerning this that he mentions in another place in detail is that which is reported from Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma concerning the ayat, as for those who can fast with difficulty, meaning the elderly man, the elderly woman, then they have a choice either to fast or to feed a needy person for every day. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, turjuman al-Qur'an, the one who the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught the meaning of the Qur'an, he said concerning this ayat, permission has been given to the elderly man and the elderly woman in this matter of the obligation of fasting. While they might be able to fast, but with difficulty, they have permission to abstain from fasting if they want to, and instead feed a needy person for each day not fasted. And there's no qadha, yani making up the mixed days, required of them. And he went on to say, and the pregnant woman and the breastfeeding woman, if they fear of some harm from fasting, may abstain from fasting and feed a poor person for every day not fasted. This is the statement of Abdul ibn Abbas. The isnad or chain of narrators is qawi, strong, reported by al-Bayhaqi rahimahullah yani in his sunan. Also reported from Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma that he said, if the pregnant woman fears for herself some harm from fasting, or the breastfeeding woman fears for her child during Ramadan, yani some harm due to fasting, they may abstain from fasting and feed a poor person in place of every day not fasted. And they are not required to make up the missed days of fasting, Abdul ibn Abbas says. And this narration is reported by Tabari, rahimahullah, and Shaykh Al-Albani, rahimahullah, said that it is sahih, according to the conditions of Al-Imam Muslim, reported in Al-Wa' al-Ghalil in the fourth volume, hadith number 19, or page 19. And finally, it has also been reported from Nafi'i, rahimahullah the Mawla, and student of Abdullah ibn Umar, radiallahu anhuma. Yani, or Nafi says, concerning Abdullah ibn Umar, a daughter of Ibn Umar was married to a man from the tribe of Quraysh, and she, yani Abdullah ibn Umar's daughter, radiallahu anhum ajma'in, was pregnant and was struck by thirst during the fast of Ramadan. So Abdullah ibn Umar, radiallahu anhuma, ordered her to break the fast and to feed a poor person for every day not fasted. And the isnad of this narration is sahih, reported by Ad-Darqutni, and Shaykh Al-Albani mentions it in Irwa' al-Ghalil, also, and in the fourth volume, page 20. And these are some of the evidences that Shaykh Al-Albani has mentioned in a number of different places that show, yani, from amongst the companions of the Prophet, that Abdullah ibn Abbas and Abdullah ibn Umar held the view. And it wasn't ijtihad that they just made up by their own mind, rather it was from their understanding from the Prophet ﷺ that the pregnant woman and the breastfeeding woman is exempt from fasting. If they are not able to fast, they merely have to feed a poor person. And this is a tremendous facility and an ease for women, especially women who are having children, and they might be pregnant this year and breastfeeding following it, and pregnant the next year and breastfeeding following it. And when will they make up the days? When will they make up the days? 30 days and 30 days and 30 days. And maybe it's no end to it for some women. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them the facility, yani, of feeding a poor person in the same way as the condition of the elderly man and elderly woman. And I'm saying this because the majority opinion of the scholars is that the pregnant woman and breastfeeding woman, if they don't fast, they have to make up the days later. And they also have to feed a poor person. And some say they only have to make up the days, and they're varying opinions. But what is correct is that they do not have to make up the days. Rather, they have to feed a poor person for every day, and the matter is finished.
أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتٍ فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيضًا أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ فَعِدَّةٌ مِّنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخَرٍ وعلى الذين يطيقونه فدية طعام مسكين فمن تطوع خيرا فهو خير له وأن تصوموا خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون